Okay, 34. Proposition 34 would repeal the death penalty in California and replace it with a punishment of life in prison without the possibility of parole. Let's talk about this for a minute. What it's basically 17 of 297 persons exonerated through DNA evidence served time on death row. And the true suspects and or perpetrators were identified in 146 of these cases. So I think what they're trying to say is that death penalty is not perfect. Supporters who want to repeal the death penalty, they say that more than 100 innocent people have been sentenced to death in the United States, and some have been executed in the United States. And Prop 34 keeps criminals who commit heinous crimes in prison until they die and requires them to work. And as opposed to, I guess, giving them the easy way out. The death penalty does not make us safer, better crime solving does, according to the supporters. Prop 34 saves hundreds of millions of dollars and redirects those hundreds and millions to law enforcement, is what the supporters say. The argument here that the supporters are putting up is that it costs much more to keep a person on death row through the system with all the legal roads that they have to take rather than to keep the person in jail for life. Now, opponents argue that abolishing the death penalty would cost taxpayers $100 million more over the next 4 years and many more in the future. They say that the death penalty is given to less than 2% of the murderers, those guilty of the most heinous crimes. And they say that data suggests that abolishing capital punishment will result in increasing long-term costs for lifetime housing and health care of murderers. And Prop 34 lets murderers who commit crimes with circumstances escape justice, is what the opponents say. And the supporters include Gil Garcetti, and the supporters include Jean Woodward, who's warden of California Death Row Prison, League of Women Voters, John Van de Kamp, who's Attorney General of the State of California, Mayor Antonio Villaraigosio, and Villa, whatever. And Judge LaDoris Cordell, who's retired. And let's see, the opponents include Californians for Justice and Public Safety, and the San Francisco Chronicle Editorial Board, and Pete Wilson, former governor of California, and Mark Klass, who's the father of 12-year-old murder victim Polly Klass. California State Sheriff Association opposes it, and California District Attorneys Association opposes it. Those are the major. Now, any questions on this one? Okay.